Welcome to an example on how to find the five-number summary of a data set. The five-number summary consists of these five values: the minimum, the lower quartile or Q1, the median or Q2, the upper quartile or Q3, and the maximum. These five data values divide the data set into four groups with about 1/4 or 25% of the data values in each group. We also use these five values to create a box plot, also called a box and whisker plot. Notice how there's a note here at the bottom that says use the locator percentile method described in the book, not the calculator, to determine Q1 and Q3. There's more than one method to determine the lower and upper quartiles, and therefore it's important to make sure we use the correct method. So for our class, we don't want to use the T84 because it uses a different method, which can sometimes lead to different quartile values. Next, notice how the given data is already in order from least to greatest. If it wasn't, we would have to order the data. Let's begin by identifying the minimum and maximum values. Notice how the minimum is 3.2 and the maximum is 27.3. Now let's find the median or Q2, and notice how because we have a total of 10 data values or an even number of data values, the median is not going to be a value in the data list. If we were to divide the data in half, it'd be between the fifth and sixth positions, or between the values of 8.3 and 13.8. So because we have an even number of data values to find the median, we're going to find the mean of 8.3 and 13.8. So the median is going to equal 8.3 plus 13.8 divided by 2, which is equal to 22.1 divided by 2, which equals 11.05. So the median is 11.05. If we take a look at our notes on how to determine the median, it states that the number of data values is even, which is our case. There is no middle value, so we find the mean of the two values in the position of n divided by 2 and n divided by 2 plus 1. If the number of data values was odd, then the median would be the data value in the middle. This can be found by determining the position n divided by 2 and rounding up to the next whole number. But again, because we have an even number of data values, our notes tell us to take the number of data values, which is 10, divide by 2, which is equal to 5. So we'd find the mean or average of the two data values in the fifth and sixth positions, which notice how we already did. Now let's find Q1 and Q3. And again, we're directed to use the locator percentile method. So for review, again, the data has to be in order from least to greatest. Once it is, to find Q1, we use the locator formula L equals 0.25 times N, where N is the number of data values. If L is a decimal, we round L up to the next whole number, and we use that position as Q1. If L is a whole number, we find the mean of the data values in the Lth and L plus 1th positions. We find Q3 in the same way, except we use the formula L equals 0.75 times N. So to find Q1, we'll use the locator formula L equals 0.25 times, in this case, 10. Which is equal to 2.5. So because we have a decimal, we round up to the next whole number, which would be 3, which means Q1 is in the third position. So looking at our data, notice how 7.4 is in the third position, and therefore 7.4 is the median of the lower half of the data, and also Q1. And now to find Q3, we'll use the locator formula L equals 0.75. times 10. So 0.75 times 10 is equal to 7.5. Because we have a decimal, round up to the next whole number, which is 8, which means Q3 is in the 8th position. Notice how 20.9 is in the 8th position, which means 20.9 is the median of the upper half of the data, and therefore is equal to Q3. So now we have our five-number summary. Five-number summary is 3.2, comma 7.4, comma 11.05, comma 20.9, comma 27.3. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.